Cameroon is going through a very serious political crisis at the moment, and there are many reasons for this, but the most important one, as you all know, is the Anglophone crisis, which has been going on for 8 months now and without any end in sight. There are many reasons for this, and in fact, the Anglophone problem could not have bubbled up at a very worse time for our country, because our country has a lot of other issues that it needs to resolve. We're fighting Boko Haram in the north, and that is expending a lot of resources. When you look at the eastern region, our borders of the eastern region is extremely porous, and that creates a significant security risk for the country. There are many issues as well. Our country right now, we are having a lot of financial difficulties. Our revenues last year has dropped significantly because of a variety of reasons. Oil prices remain very low. They are not, our commodity prices in the international markets have not rebounded. And that is making it difficult for government to meet certain basic social services. You see doctors protesting, teachers are protesting for non-salary payments. Some teachers have not been paid for more than 5 years. If you look at that and you realize also that citizens really are extremely distrustful of government. This is even worse when you look at the legal sector. In Douala recently, many young folks, citizens, and do not trust the legal system to be able to render justice anymore. I mean, that's no surprise to all of us. And mob justice is becoming rampant. That is a problem. All of this portends really difficult situation going forward for the country. It is important. In fact, right now, our country is at the crossroads. The government can either choose to continue down its current path, and which will lead to final implosion, or it can really undertake fundamental transformational changes in order to get our country out of this crisis. We believe that a transitional government, without the current president, President Biya, as the leader of that transitional government, is really the best option to get our country standing tall again and roaring as indomitable lions. This transitional government, we believe, should be for about 3 to 4 years to give the transitional government time to ensure that the change is smooth. It should be led by technocrats. These are people, it should be people who are known to be very competent in their different fields and should not be political leaders. They should not be leaders of any political parties. It is also important that this transitional government be responsible for three main key issues. One, ensuring that all Cameroonians enjoy freedom of speech across the territory, and that there is freedom of press as well. There should be nothing like this. You see the CNC passing gag orders that the media cannot use words like federalism and things like that. All of that needs to stop. The second most important thing that this transitional government should be responsible for should be trying to build confidence to start the process of building confidence in the citizens trusting the legal system of the country. There have been many issues in our legal system, the incarceration of Mbala and Fontem and lots of that. We know of the Paul Erikinge and many other a masquerade of justice in the country. The transitional government would be in charge of ensuring that legal statutes across the country is respected. The third, probably most important thing that the transitional government should be tasked with doing is to convene a national constitutional convention to be able to draft the constitution for the Second Republic of the country. And this is important because if you look right now, federalism is probably the minimum expectation of most Cameroonians. Most Cameroonians want to be able to elect their governors. We know from our studies that 90% of Cameroonians believe that the country is headed in the wrong direction and that the current government does not have the resources or the know-how or the credibility to be able to rescue the situation. So we are really in a very difficult situation right now. It is important that each and every one of us, we look each other in the eye and be able to deal with these very difficult issues. We can choose to say we are going to have elections next year and comes like that, but the fundamentals of our country is not strong. If the fundamentals continue to worsen, especially given the fact that the Anglophone crisis is not going to be resolved any soon without transformational leadership, then we are in for the long haul. Be that as it may, our position is that we would need to have a reset in the country, similar to what happened in Ghana, in Nigeria, and other recent countries. We need to take the time to be able to make it right. This is the time. We should not be wasting more time.